incident. It should not have happened. There are two messages from this incident. Message number one, if false information is spread against any innocent person, how that innocent person will feel? What is the ultimate result of it? Who should know it? Whether it is Twitter, whether it is Facebook, whether it is radio, whether it is the media, both electronic media, other medias, they should verify. The falsehood should not be spread like this. For that, this is the sacrifice that has been done. One should feel for that. Another thing, second message is very clear. One should not get weak-minded. If some false messages are spread, then what one has to do? It should be ignored. One should have the courage. One should have the willpower to face it. Now, so many thousand children, they have seen it today. What is the message we are giving to the entire world? The message would be that something happens. If some false messages are sent, whether one should commit the suicide? One should not commit the suicide.
Who do you think is responsible for this tragedy?
This tragedy, the first is that, you know, that radio people, they should not have done it. See, after expressing condolences will not be sufficient. Another message that has been sent to the world, that one should be very, very bold and one should face any incident. But
what would you like to say to those radio presenters now at the funeral of Jacinta Saldana?
Yes. You have seen with your own eyes the children have attended the funeral. Am I correct? School children, college children, and also the public. If somebody tells false things, whether they should commit the suicide? The persons who have sent that false messages, inquiry should be held, investigation should be done. That is, the government of England is very, very serious about this matter. They should have the thorough investigation.
Do you think the hospital is responsible? It should have provided a better duty of care?
That is, I tell you, for all of them. That is vicarious liability. When you are appointing somebody, you should be also very careful. Your hospital authority should be very careful. And also, the radio people, they should have the control over their staff. They also utterly failed. That is what had happened in this case. Now, the entire world is shaken. But one thing, by sacrificing her life, she had given one message. That it should not happen in future.
Could you sum up for me the sense of loss and how people are feeling within the community here?
Within the community, they are very, very sad today. It is not only their family. You forget that it's their community. All the people, Hindus, Muslims, Christians, all the caste and religion of the entire world, today they are feeling. No, it should not happen. Don't confine it to one community. Indian investigation, they cannot do the Indian investigation there.
So they wanted one more.
I tell you, they cannot do that there. It is the jurisdiction of England, of that country. See, there is law for the every country. If such incident has happened, if, for example, murder takes place here.
Hear me. They have impersonated the royal family.
Arey bhaiya, I am just telling you, that is why they have to do. Indian government cannot do that anything.
Have you spoken?
They don't have the power at all. There is international law also. But United Nations can take cognizance of it. They can take cognizance of it.
Sir, you have been been a speaker in the United Nations before. Would you press for a better media ethics in the future?
For your information, I am nothing today. I am not even
sir,
a panchayat member.
It's not that.
I am telling
you. Statesman.
No,
you have grown up.
No, no, brother. One thing I tell you, I must tell the truth. For the defeated people now, even though I won 4 times in Lok Sabha and 2 times I won Rajya Sabha, Upper House, But today I have nothing. The atmosphere is shaken in everybody, I say. The noble soul, whether I tell you, it is, what is the information that has come to me is that even England, the people are worried about this. You should not have. They are feeling for that. Then not only England, entire world is feeling how the false information can destroy the noble soul. She is a noble soul.
प्रत्येक सावन तिचा कुट फादर हो एक वॉर आगार एक बरी पतीन सावन एक बई पासी आवई सावन आनी एकल्यांचे कष्ट समजली व्यक्ती तिचा मरणातही आम्ही दुख पावतावन करे पण आम्ही जीवन ख्रिस्ताचेर पावंट दवरले पसा ताणे मरण पवल्या कुटमादरांक बुजयले लाजरसच्या मरणावेळी कुटमासवें जीस विरुण उरलो तांकां धीर आनी बुजवन पाठयले तोच ख्रिस्त जसिंताक सस्नेक जिवीत फावो करून दी आनी ताच्या पतीक दोगां भुरग्यांक तशें कुटमादरांक बुजवन आनी धैर्य दिवन म्हणून ह्या पवित्र बलिदाना वेळार आमी प्रत्येक तरान मात घेया आमचे हे बलिदान देवाक मनवसरते जावच्या आमचे उणेपण आमी वळपण घेवया प्रार्थया देवांच्या बापा तुझ्या गोपान पात्यान मेळटा का पुळकीचो सागो आनी भगवंतान सुखाचो संदी जसिंता आमच्या भयणीची कूड आज आमी भावपणाच्या मोगान मातयेक लायता तर त्या विनाशी जिवीताच्या बनपासान तिका सोडून तुझ्या विसरलेल्या संगती सृष्टीच्या सुखात वाटोली आणि पुनर्जीवनपणाच्या दिशा पुढे अज्ञासहित टीका रूप भोगून पावे आमच्या सुमिया तुझ्या पुता जिजू ख्रिस्तावरती परा देव तुझे सवय पवित्र जियता निरास्पर्श लेता ससनाचा ससना
Continue with today's proceedings. Since I am totally tired and exhausted, my friends and our family friends, on my left is Rocky Dikuna and Mr. Steven Almeida and Jacinta's brother and my brother-in-law Naveen. They will conduct the proceedings. So I will hand it over to Steven.
I've shattered our lives. And we barely have any strength to grieve and sorrow. This unprecedented tragedy which is unfolded in our lives with the sad demise of our loving sister Jacinta, beloved wife of Benedict and loving mother of Junelle and Lisha. The incidents leading to this tragedy is being investigated by the London Metropolitan Police, and they have assured us a full and fair investigation. We want to thank everyone for your enormous support and words of comfort. Your support means a lot to us. Please do keep us in your prayers. We now would like to specially thank Right Honorable Keith was MP, chairman of the Commons Home Affairs Select Committee, UK, for the supporting and guiding us through these sad, hard and difficult times. We thank Indian High Commission in London for assisting us to bring Jacinta back to India. Our special thanks goes to British High Commission in India. Our sincere thanks goes out to Ministry of External Affairs, Government of India. We thank Mr. Oscar Fernandez, Member of Parliament, Mr. R. Ashok, Home Minister, Government of Karnataka, Mr. Jay Prakash Hegde, MP, Mr. Sadananda Gowda, ex-Chief Minister of Karnataka, Mr. Ivan D'Souza, KPCC Secretary, Mr. Gaffu and various leaders for their condolences and support. We also would like to thank Most Reverend Gerald Lobo, Bishop of Udupi Diocese, Reverend Father Stanley Tauro, Parish Priest of Our Lady of Health Church, Shirwa, and all priests and nuns for their prayers and consolation. We thank the media for respecting our privacy, and we continue to urge you to do so. Right. As you heard on the newspapers, news media and everything, there are three notes are found. The Scotland Yard investigation, the Met Police investigation are on. And we've seen the notes and everything, but the contents will be safe. We know we are not disclosing the content at the moment. We are waiting for the inquest to complete.
And do you suspect any pressure on her? What did she say when she came back home?
I can't comment.
To the people, no comments. Woman,
family? No comments.
Will Benedict then, go back to England and
reorganize
there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, definitely, yes.
And will continue to be a footballer?
Yes.
He is. He's also a referee, so he'll continue to do the football and refereeing thing.
And Isha's education there?
Yes.
So they will be coming back to England?
No.
Absolutely no.
And are all the three of them British passport holders?
Yes.
Including Ben?
Yes.
And there was one report saying that initially that Ben was not, the family members of Ben were not able to get in touch with Ben in London after their tragedy unfolded. Is that in
That's untrue. That's untrue.
Were the family members in constant touch with Ben?
That's untrue. Yes.
They were in touch with Ben.
Yes.
So they knew what was happening with Ben.
Yes. Not exactly what is happening around the incidents. We are, for a certain degree, we kept our secrecy. We are not disclosing as of today. We are not disclosing it. But they are in touch. They are in touch.
They were in touch.
Yes, yes. Of course, yes.
So there were media reports that Jacinta had a dispute with a colleague at the hospital.
No comments.
So anything specifically that you want to say about this case?
No. Whatever I wanted to say, I already made mention in my
It's in the early stages of the investigation. Investigation is going on.
Are you urging for investigation against the radio jockeys also who made that call?
No comments at the moment.
Alex Rossi from Sky News. Do you envisage, against the hospital, because perhaps they had a duty of care for Jacinta? Is that a possibility?
I can't comment on that right now. We have to waiting, as you know, this kind
do
of...
Do you envisage a scenario where that might be possible?
I can't comment on that at this moment because we are, it is investigation. Are you aware the UK thinks the investigation are on? We are looking forward to the inquest to accomplish. Once that happens, then we'll make an appropriate decision at appropriate time.
And sir, I'm from the Australian newspaper.
Yeah.
And likewise, has the family considered what action they might like to see taken against the two radio announcers that started this all?
We are not yet decided anything. The family is grieving, and as per the Prime Minister David Cameron said, they need some time and space. Please.
Have those announcers or the radio station attempted to contact the family to apologise themselves?
Not yet. We'll give you 2 minutes, then I'll accomplish this briefing.
Did you read the compensation that was given by...
Yeah, compensation kind of a thing. The family is grieving and we're waiting for the results of the case.
Any reason for not showing the body, opening the coffin?
Because we don't want to dispose the case of our sister Jacinta, and media is uncontrollable inside the church, and that made us to put the lid on, not to photograph the picture.
Any particular grievance against the media in general, right from
UK to? No grievances, please. No comments. I don't make any comments on the media. No, please.
I'm still with the grief, so
I'll answer that. Leave it.
I think I will take some time.
May I answer your question, please?
Please, sir.
Yeah, go on, please. Ask the question.
Sir, still grieving, but yeah. Has he given any time to what steps he'll take when he returns to the UK with his family to start to try and rebuild their lives?
That's what I said, sir. What happens is we have to waiting for the inquest. Let the inquest report come in. This is only interim inquest is over. Inquest is on 26th of March. Once that accomplished, then the family will sit together and make a decision. And to give some time to the family to grieve, you understand that better? I hope, sir.
So when will the family return to the UK?
It's not yet decided. We are here for Christmas.
The compensation that was given by, that was announced by the...
We don't know any compensation kind of a thing. The family is grieving and we're waiting for the results of the case.
Any reason for not showing the body, opening the coffin in the church?
Because we don't want to dispose the case of our sister Jacinta, and media is uncontrollable inside the church. And that made us to put the lid on, not to photograph the picture.
Any particular grievance against the media in general, right from UK to...
No
grievances,
please. No comments. I don't make any comments on the media. No comments.
Mr. Papa, I'll hand you one thing. When you go back to the UK, have you had any time to think what your first steps are going to be as you try and rebuild your family's lives?
I'm still with grief, so I'll answer that, please. I think I will take some time.
May I answer your question,
please?
Yeah. Ask the question, I didn't get your question.
I'll ask it again. Yeah. Obviously, sir, still grieving, but has he given any time to what steps he'll take when he returns to the UK with his family to start trying to rebuild their lives?
That's what I said, sir. What happens is we have to wait for the inquest. That inquest will not come. This is only interim inquest to go. Inquest is on 26th of March. Once that accomplished, then the family will sit together and make a decision. And now, please. What happens is this is the time we need to give some time to the family to breathe. You understand that better? I hope so.
So when will Ben and the family return to UK?
It's not yet decided. We are here for Christmas.
Sorry. Francis Hill from Times of London. Today's arrangements, did they follow, it's been reported that Jacinta left instructions. I assume that today's
I didn't get your question.
It's been reported that in one of the notes, Jacinta left very detailed instructions as how she wanted this affair to be conducted. I'm assuming that it's been conducted entirely in her wishes and that she wanted to be buried here in Shiva. Is that correct?